Pier Francesco Maranna will give us the urban perspective from Milano.
Good afternoon. I think in those days we learned many things. I would start with the one that I learned in the speech before by William Mumau. The fact that we don't have to talk about reforestation, but we are proforestation. It's interesting, especially if we talk about cities, because when we have plans for new urban forest, we don't have to think that we move back to the past, but that we are trying to reinvent a different future for our city. It is important for a city like Milan, and I'm honored to talk about our project here, but it's similar on what the other European cities involved in urban forest are doing, and we are working together because we have... We have a similar project and we are facing similar problems. First theme, and I would focus mainly on problems, because even in the city, it's easy, citizens say, okay, why don't you just plant trees? But I would say that if you have a project, you have to treat for urban forestation like it's an industrial process. And it's as complex as an industrial process. So first, I think that the main, the first step is to create a solid institutional alliance, because usually it's a push that comes from the city, but you have territories that are usually in the towns around the city, so you have to work together. So we work together with the city and the metropolitan area. We work together with the universities of the city. We work together with the parks around the city of Milan, because they have the experience on what means to create new parks and new green areas in an urban in the urban elements. But if we go on goals, you probably know and. Everybody could agree on that. I would focus especially on the critical points, because that are the main things I think we should work on, and we could also find solution together. First, we need to study the territory and to see where we can find the new areas and what is the beginning point. It's not well known in every cities we compared with, because we usually know very well what we build, but we don't know very well what we left green year by year. And as even as you said in other places, we too, we have good knowledge of the public side of the green, but a few information on the private side of the green. So that is the main part. Second, you have to create new financing models to push on green, because in every balance from nation to the city, green is always has got a short balance. So if you have to enlarge it, you have to find a connection between public and private investors to obtain results. And you need a new governance model. I would focus mainly on the fact that, and it's connected with the last point of maintenance cost, that we are used to say how much we have to invest. Okay, we have to invest for forestation, but how much we need to maintain well what we have and to maintain well what we create as new areas. So mapping is the first work we did and the first work we are doing. If this is the metropolitan area of Milan during the day, probably you wouldn't imagine what exactly the city center is. But if we go by night, we can imagine it better. So we see that there is a difference from 4 to 7 degrees from day to night in a city like Milan in the city center, while outside we have a system that is quite normal, I would say. We mapped many parameters of our cities. We work on the fact that the green infrastructure are connected to blue infrastructure, and so also it's also a way to reimagine areas around the river in the cities. So we created a strategy for deforestation. We use the term forestamy, so we can stay even in pro-forestamy. That is a good solution. And it says that, of course, we have to work on the permeable areas, but we have also to work on green roofs for heating. We have to work on urban gardens, on networks of green and blue areas, and on the system of orbital forest around the city. So this asks us to reinvent all the system in the city. For example, we had big parking places without trees. Now we are making new rules with, for example, for every parking place, you have to plant 2 trees in that area. So to reimagine even every part of the urbanized city. The difficult part was to find a new project, especially around the city of Milan, where we have more disponibility of areas to work, but we had the problem of money and of maintenance. That is, we will see later that, but because the two main themes I would focus is, first, what is the connection between urban forest and what we can do around and far from the city. Of course, we have to work close to the city. We have an idea to plant 3 million of trees till 2030. Of course, it's not a question of numbers, but it's a question of invent a different future for city. But to have also some goals on numbers, it could help to reach the result. So, for example, we arrived at 100,000 new trees last year. We want to arrive to 400 new trees in 3 years. And then we want to go up to arrive to 2 million for the Olympic Games and 3 million at the end of the process. This is quite important because, as we said, it's an industrial process. So we also need, nobody would give 3 million of trees to the city of Milan tomorrow, luckily. But if we work on the idea that in 10 years we can arrive there, we can create an alliance between the cities and areas far from the city, where they can create a new plant nursery and also take care of a part of the cities that is, of the territories that is quite abandoned. If we see the numbers in Italy, the forests are growing up. That is good on one side, but not totally good because it is because we lost the control of some part of the territory and we don't manage it. While I think that even outside the city, we need to manage and to govern the fact that the forestation are growing up. So we have the goal to arrive at 20% of canopy tree cover for our city in 10 years. That means that actually we are low, but that we have a potential that is quite important. The second point I want to focus is the cost of the project and the fact that the investment is, of course, an important cost, but it's nothing compared to the cost of maintenance. And if we move to the national level and even to the European level, I think that is a new challenge because we are used, especially on environment and on climate, to have the idea that we have to push new investment and contribute to reduce day-by-day expense. If we work on green, I think that taking care is even much important than investments. So we have to focus the fact that maintenance is one of the motivation because cities and administration, they didn't invest in the past on green because it's a future cost, but it's a part of the defense of the system. And so in all the project, actually in Italy, the national government made a new fund for forestation in urban areas. We are very happy, but we have to go in this direction. Even on the European rules, I think we should consider it. Actually, we have planted 2 years ago 80,000 plants, trees. As you said, as we showed you, we arrived at 1,000. We have to multiply 4 the results in the next decade. It's not easy, but it's a challenge that can change our landscape. That is what's happening in the areas we are working together with citizens, with associations, and create the awareness that forestation is not a standalone policy, but is a part of the creation of a new idea of cities of the future. I stop on the other side. All the cities, for example, Paris also has got a big forestation program. We have always the problem that, okay, we know the city, but not the places around. This shows the effort, the results, and even the fails on involving other towns around Milan on the process. Many participate with great results. Many, they still are not part of the plan. Bringing together more than 100 towns, it's a real job, and it is a part of this job. These are areas of possible intervention we defined with those towns. So I think that we are fighting a new challenge that is, of course, in areas far from the city, but even the cities are involved in this challenge, even because they are the biggest responsible of many of the problems we are facing. Many cities are part of the process. We are at the beginning in many of the cities, so now we know what the problems are, and that is the best way to try to solve and to realize those projects. Thank you.